Childcare fees will still be significantly reduced with the enhancement of preschool subsidies, despite the recent announcement that 330 childcare centres are raising fees next year.
Manpower Minister Josephine Teo gave the reassurance during a radio interview with CNA 938 this morning. Kelly Wong reports.
The announcement by the Early Childhood Development Agency earlier this month said the median increase is within 5% of fees and broadly comparable with previous years. Among those upping their fees, PAP Community Foundation and Star Learners. The news had drawn unhappiness from parents. Mrs. Teo, who's assisting on population matters, says that these centres are anchor and partner operators and they receive government funding to keep fees low. But they also have a fee cap to adhere to. The recent fee increase is due to anchor and partner operators harmonising the fees. She assures Singaporeans that with the new rise in subsidies, they can expect to pay less.
Now let's say the preschool raises fees by $20 yep. within the 5% cap. Mm-hmm. With the new subsidies coming into effect,
they still pay much less.
They pay much less. Right. They will pay yep. $130. Right. So from $350 to $130 is still a significant reduction.
Right.
On the citizens panel discussing work-life harmony, Mrs. Teo says the government has received very good responses, but is mindful that the panel should not get too big. She says the panel is kept at slightly more than 50 members, a good size to work with. And should the recommendations be strong enough, she's open to the possibility they could become law one day. On parenthood, Mrs. Teo says Singaporeans should reorder their life priorities if they want to have children early. She recognizes that this generation has competing priorities, such as career and personal pursuits. Sharing her own experience, Mrs. Teo says she and her husband reprioritized their needs and wants when the children came.
My husband and I are really, we love to travel. Mm-hmm. And when we were younger, you know, we did a lot of backpacking. We used to go to a lot of places that I think could be considered a little too adventurous.
Oh,
so
wow.
When the children came, mm-hmm. If we traveled, it was always to more, how shall we say,
family-friendly areas.
Very family-friendly, mm. meaning that, okay, if something happens, we know that there will be a hospital nearby. We actually moderated our travel for a good 8 years or so. About 8 years. And then when the kids were about 8 years old, we looked at each other and said that, no, we've got to get back to the kind of travel we want.
She hopes that the government can send a strong signal to tell young people who want to marry and have children that it's achievable and enjoyable.